Good evening, Dell community, and welcome to fabulous Las Vegas, Nevada. We're here kicking off our coverage of Dell Tech World. My name is Savannah Peterson, joined for all the fun with Dave Vellante. Dave, I am so thrilled to be back at the show with you this year.
Yeah, it's a good show. This was the first show. I mean, it was EMC World back in 2010.
Yeah.
Of course, now Dell, of course, owns EMC, so this got it all started.
I know, it did. You just had Michael on, and now we have two other fantastic guests. Please welcome Bob and Rob to the show. Thank you so much for being here, guys.
Hey, guys.
Great to be
here.
Thanks.
We get you back on for the first time since 2019.
I was here in 2019,
You're
that's
CUBE
right.
You're CUBE OG.
Talking
I love
SQL
that.
19 back then, that's right.
Well, yeah. And how appropriate that you are here to talk to us about the very big announcement of SQL 2025. Tell us all about everything that just got dropped this week.
No problem, Samantha. So today, Satya Nadella, our CEO, announced the public preview of SQL Server 2025. I've been here now at 32 years at Microsoft, so for me it's just a personal blessing that all of a sudden now we have a new version of SQL Server. I've seen it all, from diskettes now to AI, which is what we're focusing on. We have a cool new logo.
I love the logo.
That we
I know,
introduced
that's
today
I know.
For SQL 25. And you know, one of the things that Satya talked about is AI, obviously, right? Big theme here of this show. Say AI being built in is a major part of this release, there's no question. We'd love to somehow dive and talk more about, especially because Michael talked a lot about data and AI today in the keynote.
Absolutely.
But this is the largest release for SQL Server developers in a decade. So much poured in for devs. I'm going to leave here. Unfortunately, I'd love to be here all week, but I'm going to go to Microsoft Build tomorrow and start talking to developers also about this event, this release. But you know, for SQL Server, the core engine, security, performance, availability, we have to have that, or we don't have a release. And we've done some 40 new features of engine type things in this release as well. So, a lot packed in, we're pretty excited about it.
It sounds like there's a lot going on. What does that mean for all the fabulous Dell customers who get to take advantage of that?
Well, you know, Microsoft and Dell, long time, and there's a lot of SQL Server.
Yeah, you guys are OG partners.
We are,
yes.
Yeah, in the best way.
There's a lot of SQL Server running on premises, on Dell Kit, with Dell Compute, with Dell Storage. We have a lot of different solutions we've written together.
Yeah.
And the beauty of it is, we can extend with the API-driven SQL Server 2025 and the AI solutions, this only makes it more robust for on-premises customers because there's so much SQL Server running on our kit.
Dell is one of the largest installation bases for us in the world.
Wow.
Yeah, absolutely, on-premises, right? So for us.
I mean, it makes sense.
It makes sense. And we've been that partnership from the very beginning to now, so it's very exciting to be at this event and just continue to talk about that evolution of our partnership.
So what are the salient aspects of 25 that we should know about, SQL Server 25?
Yeah, well, AI being built in is such a big thing. You know, Michael talked about data and AI today. For Microsoft, we say data fuels AI. Like, you don't have AI without data, right? And SQL Server being this base of data for Dell customers for years, so now all of a sudden, customers can now build AI applications, but securely. Do it in the SQL engine itself, but communicate with AI models wherever they live, ground or cloud. So if customers are thinking about, for example, Dell AI Factory, SQL Server 25 just plugs into that because we can communicate with any AI model wherever it lives. And I saw that today, I was just looking at the keynote for Michael talking about Factory, and in my mind, I'm like, yeah, we fit right into that play. And if you're a Dell customer and you own Dell hardware, you're thinking it's Dell AI Factory solution for me, we fit right into it perfectly.
It makes perfect sense. I mean, it's such a core part of the ecosystem. Everyone has used SQL or has SQL or is familiar at least with the technology. So if I am using an older version of SQL, what's going to be the most dramatic difference that I'm going to notice when I'm exploring now or if I'm a Dell customer opening this up on my AI PC and getting to play around?
Well, it's going to be the ability to use the T-SQL language, which everybody in the world loves. They love the SQL language. Everything we do is allowed in SQL. So you're running a legacy version of SQL Server, you're finding, should I upgrade to SQL 25? Well, yeah, I need to put AI with my data now, but I have all this great T-SQL language that I've known for years that I can just use, and here's the beautiful part. I can use the security model, the scalability of the query processor to take advantage of it. So all that stuff I'm familiar with just works when you make that upgrade.
We used to joke that SQL is the killer app in big data, right? And so are there any particular industries that you guys see that are going to take this up? Is it financial services? Is it healthcare? I mean, it's ubiquitous across the board. But maybe some early signs of who's going to benefit the most and how you see that playing out.
Well, SQL Server's everywhere. It just is, like you mentioned. And you know, the funny fact on that, we were sitting back here last year when Michael said, I like
bring
this
cut.
Michael said, bring the AI to the data. And Bob said, Rob, this is what we need to do with SQL Server. Now we're here with AI with SQL Server.
Right.
It's a pretty cool story. But the industries, again, you're everywhere, we're everywhere. Enterprise, small, medium business. There's a lot of small, medium business that just needs some AI help, right? There's all this data locked up inside of SQL Server.
The cool story is just better searching. Like everybody searches their data to SQL, right? Yep. Now with like vector searching, which is this big part of this AI feature we have, we just give people better searching. And if you've got companies that want to stay on premises and do all that better searching with their data, why not use SQL Server, something that would trust to do it, but combined with the Dell hardware stack that they would love?
So we can use our GPU-enabled power edges. We can use Windows Server 2025, GPU partitioning, SQL Server there. We also have our Dell AX nodes for Azure Local, the premier solution right there. Don't forget, SQL Server runs there. SQL Server runs in a container with Azure Kubernetes service. Linux.
Yeah, we still run on Linux, containers, Kubernetes, Windows Server, all the flavors you want, doesn't matter which platform. This AI technology works with all of that.
Yeah. So vector search is now embedded in SQL Server.
Exactly.
25.
Yeah.
It's a first party citizen.
First party citizen.
And that's new, is that correct?
Brand new, yes.
Okay,
sir.
So prior to that, I would have had a bolt on, maybe an open source, you know, a Milvus or a Pinecone, but now it's embedded. So what does that mean for customers? Is it speed, is it simplicity? What does that mean for the
user? It is absolutely speed, for sure, because we have one of the most best query processors in the world, right? We also have a new vector index on top of this data using disk and technology, a popular vector index technology from Microsoft, and then security is paramount. Like, people want to be very secure with their data, so why not co-locate all these vectors with the data you already have secure with all the security model you know and trust with SQL Server? And the beautiful about the AI part, the AI models are not loaded in the engine. They're isolated from the engine. So you don't affect your actual workloads by running the AI models.
Oh, that's interesting.
Yeah.
And so if anything goes haywire, you're not damaging your data.
That's exactly
as
correct.
Well.
Right.
Which mitigates risk, which I'm sure a lot of folks adopting
that's
new
what
technology.
They're concerned about, absolutely.
Yeah.
And we support popular models, you name it, NVIDIA NIM, anything with OpenAI, Ollama, all the different popular frameworks and models that are supported for vectors. We support any of it. You pick the model, you choose it, and we can work with SQL Server to make your data better.
Are there any operational nuances or benefits that people are going to get, customers are going to get, whether it's, you know, performance tuning or space management? Are there any sort of things like that that are included? What's it mean to the
Absolutely.
Life of a database administrator?
Yeah.
Yeah, besides just AI, people are like, you know, you have this best engine here, what are you doing with this? Yeah. I kind of hit it earlier, 40 plus features across the engine for security, performance, and availability. Here's a good example. Always on availability group replicas, that's the core of availability for people, for SQL Server customers. We have like a dozen improvements to that technology. More reliable, better tuning, better diagnostics. So we're not forgetting those core DBAs that need that tried and true features of engine. You make an upgrade to SQL 25, you just get better in terms of reliability and availability.
So when you're developing this wonderful new announcement that you just had this week, what is your interface like with Dell and your customers from a usage perspective? I'm curious what the feedback loop looks like.
Yeah, Rob.
So, if we stay tuned to some announcements that are coming tomorrow from Dell.
Oh, you're sneak peeking something,
yeah,
Rob.
Yeah, I mean, what if we could take compute, storage, and maybe put all this together in some sort of way to get to this ecosystem, including SQL Server and Windows Server, or maybe you want to do anything in Linux or container? What if we could do all of that in a way that I could say, make that happen?
That sounds like a great idea.
That's, so coming tomorrow,
I mean,
the
bottom
you know,
line is that my customers use SQL, want a platform they can trust, so they look
100%.
At Dell.
Yes.
And Dell customers want to trust the database platforms and look to us. So if you look at example, just the partnership we do, we meet on a regular basis. Our engineering teams talk to each other. Our marketing teams talk to each other. It's like a step-by-step partnership.
You and I talk to
each
other.
We talk to all the time. Rob's got my cell phone number all the time about SQL Server. Now the partnership's amazing. Like I said, the biggest install base for SQL in the world. It shows all the time because our solutions look integrated together. So yeah, I can't wait to see where this journey's going to go further. I'm really excited about things like Dell AI Factory and seeing my SQL Server customers get that opportunity to use it.
That's right, that's right.
You know, it's interesting. I think it was in the last earnings call. I mean, Microsoft blew away its Azure numbers. I think it was 35% constant currency growth, which was amazing. And I think I heard that a lot of that growth came from non-AI workloads. And so you guys were talking earlier about on-prem.
Right.
Are you seeing, I mean, bring AI to the data, we're obviously big fans of that, you know, nomenclature. Are you seeing like a renewed modernization going on
Yes.
with the on-prem piece, and what's driving that?
Yeah, I don't know about you, Rob, but I see that absolutely. And this is why today, the excitement of our announcement about this next major release, it kind of proved to our customers we still care about that, right? Some customer asked me last year, do you even care about on-prem? I'm like, well, get ready. So yeah. I think us announcing even a new major version with all this innovation just proves to our customers, yeah, we do like people running in the cloud at Microsoft. We've talked about that all the time. But on-prem is still a major, major part of our business and our customer base.
And on that topic, we need more storage on-prem. So yeah. Then we bolt in PowerFlex to Azure Local to extend the storage. Of course, all our enterprise-grade storage that we already bring to the table. This just, and again, not to talk about it again, but if we could do this all in a way that's yeah, really automated, easy, right? That's going to be really awesome.
But even look today, we announced at Build, we announced Azure Local AI Foundry. So we're bringing even AI Foundry that we've proven in Azure now on premises to run AI workloads on premises.
For like a sovereign situation or latency or you know
whatever reason somebody wants to stay on prem, we're going to still.
Or I'm not moving my claim system into the cloud.
Yeah. Right? Exactly. Well, what I'm hearing here that's really great is we're not just meeting the bringing AI to where the data is. We're also meeting your customers wherever
where
they are, wherever that might be, whether that's in the cloud or on prem. Are you seeing any interesting trends in that space as the AI adoption starts happening? Are folks wanting to keep things there? Are they trusting the cloud? I mean, SQL houses a lot of sensitive data.
One of the things about our solution is really beautiful is that SQL runs an Azure SQL in the cloud. It now runs in Microsoft Fabric, Unified Platform, and SQL Server. So I've got customers running in both spaces, but they want consistency. So our AI solution works across all of those the same. So developers just build an app once and deploy it wherever they want to. And that's what they want from us. We were in a session today asking our customers, the Dell customers, are you cloud only, Azure only, cloud only, or private only, or hybrid? Everybody said hybrid.
Yeah.
So we need to meet them where they are, and that's both of those.
And just the grassroots of everybody using SQL Server, it's a platform. I remember talking to you a few years ago where, and now there's a big resurgence of SQL Server, because there's still so much data locked up there that needs to be AI-ified, maybe?
Yeah.
And
there
our
we
customers
go.
Expect us to meet the pace of innovation, right?
Yeah, or even just understood. I mean, I love that we're having this conversation. I'm thinking back to 2012, I was working for a 3D printing startup at the time, and when I wanted some insights from our BI guy, from our SQL Server, I would have to put in my request 2 weeks, 3 weeks, literally, before I would have the insights necessary to go make a market-driving decision. Powered by venture capital. So obviously speed being the name of the game right now and the velocity of innovation has never been faster. What sort of capacities, what are the magical moments that you've been getting to see as people have been testing this out and having that light bulb moment of just how much faster it is? Can you give me some examples of that?
Yeah, absolutely. So one of the things that developers see all the time is just concurrency of their data, their applications. They're always running into scenarios where they're blocking
That's
each
a great
other.
Point.
Right?
Yeah.
And so
yeah.
we've put a lot of innovation this release to do that. We've freed up developers now to not even worry about concurrency of their apps running against each other in the database. And the great story is, we tested this in the cloud. So we proved it and tested it in the cloud first and then brought it down to SQL Server so developers have more excitement or more confidence it's running well.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
You're almost a $100 billion company. You're a multi-hundred billion dollar company. So, of course, there's going to be some overlap. There's some overlap in PCs and obviously Azure is infrastructure, but generally speaking, you guys, you're much more partners than you are competitors. What does a software company look for in a hardware company, and what does a hardware company look for in a software company?
You go first, Rob. What do you look for in us?
You know, somebody that innovates and helping meeting our customers where they're at. Because right now our customers still need a little help, especially those core DBAs, those core SQL Server people.
A lot of people still need a little bit of
help.
That's
exactly right.
And I say that so lovingly, but I think those who are trying to pretend like they're really out in front right now, I mean, we're iterating, we're exploring, we're learning together. No one's really got their entire 10-year AI program and their DB architecture sorted.
I love that it's now with SQL Server, where, again, back to the beginning, SQL's everywhere.
Yeah.
Now these DBAs can do the AI things they've been trying to get to.
For me, AI, the solution is the proof point of this. Like, we build the building blocks to use AI, but we don't tell you what AI to use. We're going to go look to Dell to steer their customers, what's the right hardware, what's the right capacity, what AI model should you use. SQL has all the plumbing and connection to use it.
Bring in AI
use
factory.
Dell to make that recommendation of what to do, and that's a great proof point. We want our customers just to turn to them and say, hey, deploy models this way, SQL just connects with it.
Yeah, that's pretty sweet. You know, the first thing I did with my Dell AI PC, I'm sure this is going to be real relevant for you guys, I unboxed it, thank you, Dell, and I brought up Microsoft Copilot, and I had it design my nails for the show. Based on the Dell colors.
Copilot can do anything,
right? And my
right?
wardrobe. No, but I mean, it's all very tangible. Yeah. All right, gentlemen, I've got one very important question okay. for you, because you're a now many-time CUBE alum, and we're definitely going to have you back on. So when we're hanging at Dell Tech World 2026, what do you hope to be able to say then that you can't yet say today?
Boy.
Well, Rob wants to talk about the announcements yes. that we're talking about.
Is this being filmed?
It is, and let me tell you, I go back next. I
can tell you right
week.
Now, I look forward to 2026. I'm already scribing what we're going to do for demos and talks, and this is going to be a lot of fun next year when we have a few more pieces, stars aligning, products.
Yeah, I mean, for me, I want the industry proof points. I want to come back and say, hey, I helped this insurance company build this solution with Dell with AI. I helped this healthcare company. I want the industry big proof points to happen.
Yeah.
With public preview, before public preview, it's been hard to kind of get those things. So as we move towards general availability and even in next year, that's what I'd like to show is the industry examples.
Oh yeah, absolutely. Right.
Looking forward to that.
Wait, Rob, yeah. I'm not going to let you off the hook. You were just beginning to talk there. So what is it that you want to be able to say? I know you're talking about, you're already thinking about things for next year. Where are we going? Give me your prediction.
Being able to, again, use SQL Server from a Microsoft perspective to get that in. I mean, we have SQL Server running here on our native edge offerings as a whatever outcome you're trying to get to. Being able to put the AI with the data wherever it sits, anywhere in the customer's data center, at their edge, with the AI factory, anywhere,
yeah.
small, medium business, doesn't
with
matter.
With speed and performance,
that's
and
right.
storage, everything go with it,
with
right?
tooling, as you mentioned,
yeah.
the biggest thing about that, with the tooling that customers already know,
right.
T-SQL.
Right.
That's because you don't have to retrain. If there's other things we need to retrain on. There's a lot of things we need to retrain on. That's where a lot of automation comes
yeah.
into play too, but still, using those core tools, that makes it yeah. awesome.
That's a really great point, Rob. Yeah. Rob and Bob, thank you so much for coming to hang out. This was absolutely
yes.
fantastic.
Thanks for having
really
us.
Kicking
yeah.
off the show well for us, and thank you, Dave, always a joy.
Thank
all
much.
Of you for tuning in, wherever you might be. We're here in fabulous Las Vegas, Nevada, day one of Dell Tech World. My name's Savannah Peterson. You're watching theCUBE, the leading source for enterprise tech news.